So I like two players the most in my life. Number one is Virat Kohli, and the second one is Shoaib Akhtar. So these two players were not extraordinary because they were talented. They were extraordinary because they have done huge amount of hard work to achieve what they have done, and they have done huge amount of net practice. So players, if you see Virat Kohli itself, he was not extremely talented player, but because of the practice he has done, so he has done a lot of net practice. So when he was playing the Ranji Trophy, he was a very average player, but he improved himself, he evolved himself by doing practice as much as possible. So these two players, whether it is Virat Kohli or whether it is Shoaib Akhtar, these two players have done huge amount of hard work in their life to achieve what they have done till now. Now if you see the players, they do a lot of practice just for a performance of few seconds. If you see the Olympic winners, like for example we have Usain Bolt, so he achieved something, he created a world record of 100 meters race, and that was approximately in 8 point something seconds. In the same way, he created a world record for 200 meters race. Now that was just a performance of 8 to 9 seconds. So just to prepare for those 8 to 9 seconds, he has done a lot of practice in his life. He trained for years and years of hard work just to achieve that success. Now, in the same way, when you are preparing for your examination, if you are preparing for a UGC NET examination, you cannot just go to the examination hall without any kind of practice. So you need some practice before you actually attempt the exam. So you need some kind of, you should have attempted some kind of mock test, which is the same exams scenario kind of mock test, before you go to the examination hall, so that you can perform very well before you actually attempt the examination. Now for this purposes, every year we created the test series, and this is the best test series for UGC NET, and the maximum number of students, they are attempting our test series for UGC NET, because if you see, for UGC NET Computer Science and Applications, we are the best one which are available online, and we are the best, we are having the maximum number of students who are attempting the test series. So last year, there are approximately 1300 plus students attempted our test series, that is for the July 2018 examination. We were having approximately 1300 plus students who attempted the examination for July examination, and before that, the November 2017 examination, approximately 800 plus students attempted the examination. So this time this number is will be going around 2000 plus students that will be attempting our mock test for the UGC NET Computer Science examination. So this will give you an actual feel of the examination hall, because there also you are going to compare with the thousands of students who are attempting the test. In the same way, this is a sample number, 2000 is a sample number. You'll be competing yourself with these 2000 plus students for the test series itself. So in this video, I'm going to give you the schedule of the test series and the features of the test series. So firstly, the test series is a newly designed test series, which is having the quality test as per the UGC NET standard. As you have seen that in the previous past, there was change in the standard. So earlier there used to be three papers, that is paper 1, paper 2, paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3. Now we are having only two papers, that is paper 1 and paper 2. Okay, so these two papers are the latest change in the pattern, as well as the number of questions that is coming. And if you've seen that the examination that happened in July 2018, that was slightly more difficult, or you can say that was slightly more better as compared to the previous examination. And they have also selected some of the questions which are previous gate questions in the examination. And you should prepare yourself well before going to the actual examination hall. Now, every question in the test paper will be having fully explained and well illustrated solution, and the video solutions are available for every question. For example, if you are attempting some certain test, let us say you attempted a test for DBMS subject. Now this test will be having 40 questions, and out of these first 40 questions, if you got, let us say, 30 marks, and you got 30 questions correctly, and there are 10 questions that are not correct. Now for these 10 questions, you can go to the solution section of the test, and over there you can see the video solutions that are present for the test itself. Now you can also get a subject wise analysis of performance. For example, let us say you attempted 5 or 6 subjects, and after attempting those subjects, you find out that you are lagging behind in certain subject or a certain area in that subject, then you can prepare again for that subject, and you can attempt the next test for that particular subject. And the test will remain active until the UGC NET examination. After the examination, they will get deactivated. And there are multiple difficulty levels. So we have created two kinds of difficulty level here, that is the easy and as well as the medium. And here we'll be creating a 36 quality test for as per the UGC NET standard. Now, these papers are designed by UGC NET and JRF qualified top ranked faculties. So mostly the faculties who are designing the test papers, they are from IITs, mostly are from IIT Delhi as well as from IIT Kanpur. And these test papers are designed considering the new exam pattern as per the latest quality standard of the examination hall, latest quality questions, the number of questions of which are matching the actual standard of the examination, as well as the markings of the questions, they are aligned as per the actual exam patterns. So this is the dates when the test will be published. For example, the first test is published at 21st of July. Now it means that from 21st of July till December, you can attempt this test at any times, but you can attempt one test only at one at a time. I mean, you cannot attempt, if you, for example, you have already attempted the digital logic test, then you cannot attempt it again, but you can view the solutions. So this is the publishing dates. So the first test was published on 21st July. The second test will be published on 25th of July. The third test will be published on 29th of July, and so on. So from 29th of July till December, these tests will be available, and so on. For every particular subject, these are having the publication dates, publishing dates, and they will be till the end of the session. Okay, that is till December. So these all are the dates for the easy level test. Then we have a medium level test. These all are the dates of the medium level test. And then these are the dates of the full length mock test. So this full length mock test is as per the actual examination standard. For example, in actual examination, we are having paper 1, which is of 50 questions. And this paper 1 is of 1 hour. And then we'll be having a paper 2, which is of 100 questions, and this paper 2 will be of 2 hours. Okay, so in total, these will be 150 questions that we are going to ask. So we have created full length mock test that will be occurring in 29th of October, 2nd November, 6th November, as well as the 10th November. So that means from 10th of November till December, you can attempt this exam at any point of time whenever you like. So if you want to take the test series, then you can call us on the following numbers. You can also WhatsApp us on 9821876104 or 02, or you can also email us at admin@gatelectures.com. But apart of this, you can also visit our websites, that is digimentor.com, for our video lecture courses, or if you want to inquire for the offline classroom courses, you can visit our website. You can inquire for the offline classroom courses as well as the video lectures, and you can also visit the website, that is gatelectures.com, for the test series. So we have two websites. Gatelectures.com is for the test series. We have a separate website for the enrolled students, which are the learning management system, and a part of that, we are also having the digimentor.com website, which is the official company website. So I hope that this video was helpful for you. You can share this video with your friends if you find that they need help regarding the exam preparation, or they need help regarding the test series. So let us move on to the next video now. Thank you so much for watching.